and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a tutorial for you on this eye look, which is maybe not completely wearable, but I really felt like doing something cut crease and glam because I finally have the Jeffree Star Cosmetics Blood Sugar Palette. It's finally available in the Netherlands. I did order the Thirsty Palette off of his own website, but you know, customs and like shipping rates and everything made it sort of more expensive than my bank account likes me purchasing. So I decided, for the sake of my bank account, to wait for this one to actually end up in the Netherlands in like a Dutch web shop, so I could order it without having to spend a lot of money on it. Or at least, you know, by actually paying for the palette and not for shipping and customs and all that stuff. So yeah, but I'm really glad I finally have it. Like, seriously, it's absolutely stunning. I love the packaging. It's like, it's really like, it's heavy and it's really one of those collector's items sort of things. Like, it's absolutely gorgeous. And the colors are as well. I gotta admit, what threw me off at first when I first saw this palette was mainly that it all seemed very red to me. Like, it all seemed to be different shades of the same color. Pretty much, like, obviously the nudes are different from the reds. But what threw me off was really the red background. Like, don't get me wrong, I love, love how they, like, package this. Like, it's absolutely gorgeous. But to me, it's sort of difficult to then really judge the color scheme when I'm being distracted by the red. But now that I really like, now that I have it and I'm really looking at it, it's just so beautiful. Like, seriously, it contains not just reds and nudes, but also lovely shades of purple, burgundy. It's absolutely gorgeous. So yeah, today I decided to go for a purple and pink look mainly with a little bit of gold added to it. So let's get started. As usual, just priming my eyelids first with concealer and powder. I'm going to play it safe and go for a transition shade first, so I'm going to use Cake Mix over here. This one is just going to go in the crease all the way from like the crease line to the eyebrow, almost to the eyebrow that is. Just going to blend it out nicely so it connects as a nice transition shade. Okay, so we've got that going on and now I'm just going to use these brushes. I really hope I'm keeping them from like left to the right from your point of view. I'm never quite sure with the camera. But anyway, I'm going to use this one first, it's a very small fluffy one, then this one which is slightly more pointy and slightly more precise. Then I might even switch on to the pencil brush to be even more precise, and I'm going to continue going darker with those. I want to keep it to sort of a pink purplish theme in the crease, so I'm starting out with the shade Cavity, a very candy pink shade. And just applying that in the crease, this is going to go the furthest. I'm going to do a cut crease later, so I'm putting the crease color up here quite high. Just to make sure that when I cut the crease, it's actually still going to be visible. And time for the next shade, I'm going to go for Root Canal, which is sort of a slightly darker purple shade. I'm really just blending this very carefully to the edge of the pink. I'm applying it in the deepest part of the crease and then just blending it out. Because I really don't want to go over the pink, I really just want to build up this color in the deepest part of the crease. Yet still have the pink be visible. Then lastly I'm going to use the shade Coma, which is sort of a burgundy purple red-ish shade. It's very dark, so I'm going to use that one on the pencil brush. I'm really just going to keep this to the outer half of the crease and I'm just really patting it on. Then after that I'm going to wipe off my brush and start blending it out. Then just going back to the last brush to blend a little bit more. Now I'm going to go back to my concealer for a second just to, you know, cut the crease. I think I'm going to do a half cut crease because I think on my eye shape that just looks better, but it might still change because I'm me and I just decide stuff when I'm already at it. I always find it important to not use too much and I always like to look up for a moment so I know how high I must go. I want to keep the cut crease quite pale, so I'm going to go in with Glucose first, a white shade, and then Candy Floss, a shimmery pink. I'm using a very flat little brush for that, just to be sure that I'm really really capable of putting the color exactly where I want it. I Okay, I don't think the pink is quite saturated enough, so I'm going to use setting spray. I'm just going to go back on the eyelid, blending with Coma. I'm just going to grab Coma on a very tiny brush and darken up the crease a little bit on the inner corners. Contrast always makes a look more interesting, so that is usually a good thing, unless you're going for like a very natural look. Then onto the eyebrow highlight, because knowing me, I'll forget otherwise, so I'm just going to use glucose for that. Then I want to add something extra, which is a bit of a liner in the cut crease. For that I'm going to use First Class, which is from the Jeffree Star Cosmetics. I think it was a Christmas collection of last year, I'm not completely sure, but I got this from a friend for my birthday, so I'm pretty sure they still sell it in some places. Alternatively, you could use wet eyeshadow, like with a little bit of setting spray, or face paint, or an actual gold eyeliner. Then just some quick eyeliner, I'm going to use the one by Hema. I'm going to put a little bit of an actual glitter liner over the eyeliner, or at least the gold eyeliner, because I want it to be a little bit more glittery. I'm using this old one by Yves Rocher, but a lot of brands sell this nowadays. And then with the liquid lip by Jeffree Star, I am going to do a little bit of a flick below the wing as well, just to tie it all together, and this one is a little bit more opaque than the Yves Rocher liner. For mascara, I'm using the Sexy Pulp by Yves Rocher, because I'm also going to apply falsies. Today I'm going to go for the Rebel by Axial Beauty. Always quite a distinct difference. You could go for a more flared out pair of lashes, of course, but I felt like the purple in the outer corner would have been hidden a bit too much that way, so that's why I went for these. Okay, eyes are pretty much almost done. I'm going to do the bottom side, obviously, when I'm done with the rest of my face. But first off, I'm going to prime my skin using the Catrice Prime and Fine Smoothing Refiner. Because I want to have my skin looking good all day today, I am going to powder now, which, it's a trick that works with most foundations, but not with all foundations, so if you're not sure, try it out first. But yeah, I'm just going to apply a very thin layer, which will hopefully prevent me from going oily. This is also what I did in my video of last week of my summer foundation routine, by the way. Then for foundation, I've been using a lot of the Catrice one lately, so this time I'm going to go for the L'Oreal one instead. This is the True Match in the shade Beige, old packaging. Because I'm fake tan, so I can get away with quite a darker shade today. Just because it's quick, I'm just using a beauty blender. Then concealer, for that I'm using Light Beige by Catrice. Change of plans, on second thought, I'm going to do contouring first because I want to use a cream product and when I do concealer under my eyes I immediately want to set it. So instead I'm going to do this first. This is the Sculpting Touch Creamy Stick Contour by Kiko. Okay, then on the concealer for real, I'm not going to highlight a lot with it this time because I don't want to go over the shaper, so I'm only going to do a very little bit on my nose and on my chin, and of course underneath my eyes. And then some baking, actually only on my T-zone this time. Okay, well that's doing its thing, I'm just going to do my eyebrows and starting off with the Brow Plumper by L'Oreal. Then I'm going to use a product that I actually don't use very often despite me actually liking the product. Because for some reason, I don't know, I'm lazy with tube products. This is the Iberdell by NYX. Okay, after the 1.5 years it took me to do my eyebrows, I'm just going to blend out the powder now. Small tip, at that point you may want to go through your eyelashes and eyebrows with a spoolie just to get all the powder out. I also know for sure that my mirror isn't going to get oily at any point. Then just to blend out the contouring a little bit more, I'm going to use the Big Bold Bronzing Powder by New York Color. For some reason I always feel like cream contour looks more muddy on me than like powder contour, like especially, like I like it on my nose, but on my cheeks, nah. Hope it doesn't show up on camera, but anyway, I'm going to finish off my cheeks using the defining blush by Catrice in Think Pink. Then I'm just going to finish off my eyeballs, first off with the Bijou Color Biggie in the shade 426. Then with the palette, I'm just using Cavity almost all the way underneath my eye. Then the shade Root Canal, I'm keeping it more to the outer corner. Then lastly the shade Coma, that's really going to go in a very tiny place. Then for the inner corners I'm using Candy Floss on the same brush used earlier, but of course I really wiped it off well. And then just finishing it off with mascara. For a really intense highlight in the inner corner I'm going to use the Unicorn's Heart Highlighter by iHeart Makeup. Due to this highlighter already being very intense, I'm going to apply it before using setting spray. And then actually onto the setting spray, I'm using the one by Catrice. I missed. Now onto the lips, you could do different routes with this look really. You could go for a nude lip to make it more wearable. You could go for a pink lip, purple. I'm going for gold. And that leaves us with the final result. By the way, in case you're wondering, my hair looks like I really put thought into it and skills into it, and like I really knew what I was doing when I was doing it. I didn't. There's a donut, one of those donut things in it, but I stuffed it in there because I wanted a bit of a poofy effect, but I didn't want to tease my hair. Then realized that the donut was actually quite too small for my hair, so it looked like a weird bump in the middle, so I decided to put a braid around it. And also put lots of braids in the back to hide all the hairpins. I've got like a heap of metal in my hair right now, and then I put a flower in it to hide some more hairpins, and now it looks way more intricate and elegant and well thought out and skillful. than it actually is. But yeah, anyway, about the makeup, I really like how it turned out. I absolutely love this makeup palette. Like, the colors are beautiful, but they also blend very well. They're very intense. And yeah, I absolutely love it. So I'm definitely going to have a lot of fun with this in the future as well. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video and that you like this look. By the way, if you like this video, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to, you can also subscribe to my channel. I do a lot of makeup tutorials. Some are wearable, some are this sort of thing. Like, it depends on the person whether you find it wearable or not. And some are straight up not wearable, face paint sort of things. I also do nail art, chatty videos, just anything really I enjoy doing. Other than that, below the video you can find all my social media accounts and names. I'm mostly active on Instagram. I always post there as well whenever I upload a new video. So I'd really love it if you'd want to follow me there. I'd also post a lot of like makeup pics randomly and stuff like that. Also, of course, as always, you can find a full list of all the products I used on my face down there, including all the names of the colors I used on my eyeballs, just in case it went too fast. And yeah, that brings us to the end of this video. I really hope you enjoyed watching this. And yeah, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!